This is Easter Bunny in watercolor, a quick and easy Easter card that anyone can paint. Hi, I'm Deb Watson, and today I'm starting with my outline already traced onto my card from the outline page with graphite paper. And I'm going to wet the background behind the bunny and the egg. I'm using clean water. And you want your background to be a medium value. It can be any color you like. Today I'm going to go with green. I want the green to spread out, so I'm wetting the background so it's nicely damp. And then I mix up a puddle of green. You can use any green you like, but it's nice if you have some variation in it, like you have some yellow with your green, or you have a light green and a dark green. I'll list the colors I'm using in the written instructions. I wipe up any excess water, and I start putting my green on with the smaller brush. This is a size 6. You can see it's wet enough that it spreads a little bit. And I'm not getting a lot of variety because it is so wet. But just keep painting and get a nice medium value of whatever color you're making your background on your wet paper. If you can get fur texture on the bunny, you get extra points. Here I'm adding in some yellow to try to get more variation. And it's still a lot the same. Oops, I missed this corner over here. So I add a little bit of darker green right around the bunny. And now I'm starting to see a little variation in that color. So I'm going to quit here and sprinkle on some salt. This is ordinary table salt. And I just sprinkle on a tiny bit to see if it's going to work. And it's not doing much. That's because it's too wet. So I let the bunny sit for about 3 or 4 minutes till the shine goes off the wet paper. Then when I sprinkle the salt on, I'm going to get some effects. While that's drying, I'm going to go ahead and paint the grass in the front of the bunny. Using a light springy green, and I draw some grass in with long strokes. I draw the grass in by the egg and on the right side of the bunny. I'm just going to keep short grass under his nose. Once again, I'd like variation, so I'm doing some lighter and darker colors in the grass. See how I kind of went around the bunny's nose and the bottom of his mouth? So there's grass on the front, and once again, I'll put a little more dark at the bottom. Now I'm going to dry that, but I want to do a quick close-up so you can see the effect the salt had in the background. Next, I'm going to paint the egg. I want the egg to look like a real egg, so I'm mixing up a gray. I'm mixing some burnt sienna and some ultramarine blue to make a gray. I wet the egg down, going around the little blades of grass that are at the bottom. What I want is I want the egg to be darker at the bottom and light at the top. That'll give it some shading that makes it look realistic. I start by lifting the top of the paper to put the shading on at the bottom. Getting a smooth blend from a darker to a lighter value can be tricky, so you just have to work with it a little bit. Here I'm tilting the bunny down, pulling some of the gray up. And that's not much darker, so I'm going to make a thicker, darker wash. Having your egg darker at the bottom and lighter at the top is kind of important because it makes it look like a real egg and not just a flat cutout. So take your time and play with it a little bit. And then dry that very well. Now that my egg is dry, I'm going to mix up a pink and put the color right over top. Painting stuff in black and white is an easy way to do shadows and shading. I'm staying back from the edge so I don't get a hard edge between the red and the green. And I do put thicker pink down towards the bottom. Once again, I'm going around the grasses. And then I tilt the card up. The top is tilted up to just soften up that little bit of edge. Isn't that a nice look for your egg? Now my egg is dry and it's time for the bunny. I mixed up my own black and I'm going to make the ears very black. They'll be part of the darkest bit. So the ears have short hair. And they, where they touch the head, there's a little bit of longer hair showing. And the same on this ear, although I missed drawing the line. So now I have some really dark ears. And you could make your bunny black or gray or brown. These little Dutch bunnies come in a lot of different colors. I'm trying to make it look furry, but I'll come back with white at the end to add a few more individual strokes to suggest the fur. And once again, just like I did with the egg, I'm kind of painting around the grass. So that's the bunny's ears and back, and next I'll do his face. Now the bunny does have eyes. They look kind of like a half circle, right about there. His eyes are black and his fur is black. So they're not going to show up a lot. I just leave a little line of white between the eyes and the fur. And I left a little line between the ears and the black in the face. To mix a gray, I just mixed my black with a bit of water and watered it down. And I'm going to put some gray between the ears and the face and underneath the mouth. That's a little dark, so I dab some of it up. For the nose, I'm doing a pink line. And then I water my pink down to almost water, just a hint of color, to put in the pink area I see on the nose and the lips. I'm almost done with the bunny, so I'm using an opaque white paint and a tiny brush to suggest some white hairs coming into the black. This helps keep his face the center of interest, and it's a simple way to make it look like you did a lot of hairs. I also put a dot of white in each eye. I'd like to do a few little whiskers. They don't show up a lot, but a little bit. And I think I want spots on my egg. I'm going to try some purple spots and see how I like that. The purple spots are okay, but I think I'd rather have them be light spots rather than dark spots. So I dab some of that up and come back with my white. I'm going to put a little white highlight on the top of the egg. I put the white on very thick, rinse out my brush, and take the clean damp brush to just soften the edge on the inside. And then I come back with my white to put white dots on top of the purple. I think that livens it up a little bit. I'm going to be sending this card to my sister for Easter, so I want to make sure it looks finished and polished. I'm going to take a dark green paint and rub it around the edges to kind of frame the little picture on the card. So I take a size 6 brush with dark green paint and drag it across the edge. This creates a little bit of a dark edge around the outside. I'm using a Strathmore blank greeting card, so I'm putting double stick tape on the back of my little painting. I'm using a tape gun, but you can use a glue stick or any double stick tape. And then just center it on your card and press down. Now you're ready to go. I bet there's someone in your life who'd love to get the little card like this. So get out your paints and paint some different colored Easter bunnies today. Happy painting!